Mayor Kenny in Philadelphia and say, City of Brotherly Love, prepared to be hugged.
Now, do you guys have any sort of a bet going on?
I'm
going
to go in with a bet. I got to call him and see if he's ready, but I think that we should have a very serious but fun-spirited debate. I don't think cheesesteaks travel so well, so we'll give him a smoked salmon, but we got to figure out what we need in return.
Okay. All right. Anything else you want to add?
I just want to say, go Hawks.
You're not afraid of heights, are you?
I was just talking down there as we were climbing up those stairs. I'm not afraid of them, but I respect them, you know. So, but this is gorgeous. Sun's coming out. Quite an honor. I'm humbled to be here.
And you've never been on top of this piscina before?
Like up here? No. I don't know how you guys get those cameras up here, but kudos to you. Appreciate you having me.
Excellent. Thank you. Lofa Tip, top of the Space Needle. Have we talked about you?
We're not going any higher, right?
Maybe.
Come on. Live dangerous.
And it's the official flag, huh?
Lofa, you got to raise the flag at the stadium, right? And now you get to do it at the tip top of the Space Needle. Yeah. What's that feel like? Is there a difference between the two big honors both times?
Well, literally, it's a workout, so I'm glad I skipped my morning workout to be here with you. But yeah, it's a tremendous honor. It's always mean, you know, the world to us, and happy to be here, and go Hawks.
Are you going to be there good luck time?
If they take me on the road with them. I can still make that flight, right?
You still can.
I did have some fun playing in Philly, so, you know, let them know. Let Pete and John know.
What's good or bad about Philly, playing there?
The fans are intense. I loved it. I love going on the road. Fortunately, our team this year loves going on the road. I think we were 7-1. So, you know, I like our chances.
When you played in Philly, I mean, that was an incredible game, getting those interceptions, right? Like, do you think you might maybe KJ or one of those other linebackers, you know, follow in your footsteps?
KJ or Bobby, I would love them to see them get the hat trick, get three of those. You know, D-line put a lot of pressure out there for me when I got mine, jumped the routes, and, you know, they got to score, though. I know they'll score. I took it 100 yards total and didn't get a touchdown. I got a lot of heat from, my boys about that one. So, yeah. So I like our chances, and, you know, Russ going to have a great game. It's going to be awesome. Hopefully Marshawn sees the same holes that Penny, you know, Rashad has. You know, Penny, what do you have, 140 or something like that? So we, you know, stick to that game plan and just hopefully, you know, get those first downs on the ground. You know, we'll come out with a victory.
For those fans that aren't traveling to Philly because they can't, right, what advice, what helps players, right, because you've been in that perspective before, what can we do as 12s to help support these guys leading into the weekend?
Oh, man, I mean, just, you know, show love. You know, I know we follow all these guys on Instagram and social media. Show love, support, like we always do. And if you want, come to the Ryan House with me. Me and Alan will be at the Ryan House. So she's a celebrity. I'm the security. So
the other TV stations don't care about that.
Go check us out.
Lofa, how important is it for the Seahawks to get off to a good start in Philly?
You know what? We always finish strong. So if we could just get off to a good start, it's going to make it that much easier in the second half when we pull away. And you saw what happened last week, slow start. But just the belief with this team is so strong that, you know, we're always in it, especially with you know, Russ, Bobby, all those guys. We got great leaders.
And with Marshawn and Turbo having another week under their belt, how important is it going to be for them to feature as part of the attack early on?
Yeah, and I mean, we just got a couple runs, you know, early on because we did, you know, had an effective running game first time playing the Eagles. I think if we just bust a couple, then Russ will have some more time with the play action. They'll have to respect it. So, you know, looking forward to it. I know our guys are ready. I know our coach prepared them. So excited to see what happens.
You've coached in the league before. How helpful was it to have that moral boost from Marshawn coming in?
I mean, even if Marshawn's not Marshawn right now, because, you know, he literally said he came off the couch, but you know he's the beast, and he's beast mode for a reason. But that guy elevates everybody. As you saw when we traded for him back in 2010, he elevates everybody's level of play, whether it's the offense or the defense, because when we saw him go out there and run somebody over on defense, I mean, you know that's what we were trying to do, is, you know, get after that offense. So it's it goes off, they play off that energy.
So is the physical and the mental game totally equal? Or can you divide it into percentages?
I mean, whoever wants it more wins, and that's what it always ultimately comes down to. There's, you know, every now and then, like maybe a couple missed calls last week didn't, you know, go in our favor, but we came back, we were in it down to the 1 yard line for the final, you know, couple snaps of the game. So whoever wants it most wins, and we just ran out of time last week, and you know, I don't think it's going to be a problem going forward, especially with how good we are on the road.
you were with Pete for a while, and you know how, not only with him as a player, but you also coached with him. How, what makes them different than most coaches you've ever dealt with, and how does that favor us going into the playoffs?
Just that belief. That belief starts at the top, the belief of we're going to win. We saw it back in, what was it, 2014 NFC Championship, you know, tough game against the Packers, and just, you know, down 13 or 14 with 5 minutes, 4 minutes to go, came back. Okay, now let's get the onside. Got the onside. Okay, let's get on the score. Went to overtime, rushed through a 40-yard bomb. Like, it's just that belief resonates all the way down, you know, to the players. And it starts up top, and it's a culture that they built and that, you know, has thrived.
And the energy last week at the game, it felt like a playoff game. Walk us through that as a player, and how does that help you as a player as well?
I never go down to the field. Like, I go to a lot of games, but I never go down to the field to watch the, you know, the intros. But I knew, you know, the circumstances with the, you know, the gravity of the game, and then Marshawn coming back, and it was electric. I wanted to put pads on, you know, and just go out there. And I, you know, hadn't done that in 8 years, and I felt like I could get out there just because, like, we talk about the energy and the, you know, respect that Marshawn has. It just gives everybody that energy.
All right, well, good morning and welcome to the top of the Space Needle. It's our honor to welcome Mayor Durkin and Lofa Tatupu to raise this brand new 20-foot by 30-foot 12 flag. Mayor?
This is great, and we've got one of our all-time great Seahawk players here. We hope that we do as well in Philly as he did in Philly. He's going to raise his flag for all 12s, but we say go Hawks!
Go Hawks! Here we go.
All right, let's do this. No better city anywhere. The mountains out. The flag's going up.
Yeah! Celebrate! Let's go, man!
All right, let's do this.
Well, so we just added this white wall because we get enough people of note here that it'd be fun to have people autograph or graffiti the needle. So we installed this panel, and Lofa's the first one. We got to do it. Yeah. But underneath that is Alan Stone. He did it for the Olympics. And so he wrote on, it's just plywood under there. And so I was talking to our facilities guys. I'm like, let's get a real piece in it.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Super, super cool.
Yeah.
All right, sir. Any other questions?
Yes. What else is on your mind today? Tell me the fun facts about the flag.
Yeah, well, that flag is brand new. It's 20 feet by 30 feet, so 600 square feet. It's made of a different material to catch more wind, which isn't helping us today because I think the winds are at like 2 miles per hour. But it's 12, it's loud, we're ready to go.
Was it made in the area?
Yeah, there's a company down in Tech Weld called Rainier Industries that's made every flag for us over the years.
Is there somebody on the mod? This is flag number two?
Oh, no. This is probably flag, gosh, I'm going to guess that we've probably made somewhere between 10 and 15 different 12 flags over the years. Some of them, with the wind, they get beat up, they get torn apart. So we have to retire them as they start to age out.
And where do they go?
To my office. I've got almost every 12 flag in my office. Yeah.
You gotta have the coolest office.
My wife would call it cluttered, but I think it's cool.